Hello YouTube, this is ShadowWolf810, and on this episode of ShadowWolfs Featured Maps, we're going to be taking a look at a map called Dead on Sights. This map was made by Ump and Thump, and it's pretty good, I really like it. It's kind of fast-paced here in his video, but you're going to break the pallet, get a plasma, throw it behind the sniper, and that'll bring it into you, and then you're going to look up through the window panel there, or the wall slit, whatever. And shoot the fusion coil. Now this is a pretty nicely made hub there. You're gonna go through the overshield teleporter. Now here, I'm actually not quite sure what he does. There's obviously a weapon holder in the ceiling, and that gives him enough range to pick up the regenerator, but I don't quite understand what is about to happen next. You'll see here in a second. Basically, he's gonna throw, I think he messes up the first time, but he throws another bubble shield down, and then, like, so right now he's gonna get another one, and he's gonna throw that one, and then a mongoose is gonna fall, and frankly, I have no idea how he did that. I'm gonna have to go look at the map and see if it just kinda touched it, or what happened, but, or if it just spawns there after a certain amount of time, I'm not really sure. But once it does get there, you're going to grab onto that, hold the regenerator, or throw the regenerator, hold RB, and that's going to flip a warthog down. You're going to go back into the overshield teleporter, and there's your warthog. Just hold RB when you're going up that tube there, the radar, or the regenerator. It's going to activate a man cannon, and you'll go up that. So now what you're going to do is take your warthog and put it into this tube corner here, enough so that you can stand on it and then jump on this wedge. Then jump up, grab a sniper rifle, and there's a wall slit with a fusion coil. And then you can go ahead and fall off. Now you're going to go through the active camo teleporter and jump over this wall here, which he is seeming to have a little bit of trouble with, but now I did really like this challenge. You'll see why here in a second, because I'll go ballistic and be like, oh my god, isn't that awesome? But right here, you don't necessarily have to use the Wraith turret to do this. You can use your plasma pistol, but right here he basically just did that so that it didn't take forever. Don't do very much damage, so he just used the Wraith turret for a little bit. Then you're going to line yourself up right there, clip through the wall, and you'll get a firebomb grenade. Now you're going to drive underneath this, I don't know, I think it's an angled block, I'm not quite sure, but there's just a little opening in the wall there. You're going to take your firebomb grenade and throw it at the grav lift. And then go in and get a grav lift, and the wall moves! I was really surprised when I saw that, just because it looks like, you know, there's just a normal wall there. You would not expect for, you know, a whole wall to be able to be moved right there. But if you couldn't tell by now, you're going to bring the Wraith into this room because you can basically move the wall. I thought that was pretty awesome. That's just me, though. So, him going off of them isn't really doing anything. He's just trying to get under there. But, It takes it a while for the columns there to despawn. So through the magic of editing, I have taken out the amount of time there was in between that when the blocks were despawning so that he could drive through. But now you're going to move your Wraith over to this little hole in the wall here. And you're just going to have to move it slightly until you get it to shoot out of that hole. And basically the only place that you can shoot, like the only place it'll go through is going to be the place where you need to hit, so if you get it through, then you know it's in the right place. That's what she said, by the way, but as you can see right here, he's hitting the wall, and then that one, he got it through. That's also what she said, but now you're going to go through this teleporter here, and jump up, grab a sniper rifle, and then shoot the golf ball. Now you're going to go through the purple teleporter. Now, in this room, you're going to find a little ledge here that you can stand on, and a sword in the corner here. So you're going to jump up, grab that. Now you're going to smack the end of this BR with the sword until you can pick it up. Now, once you've done that, there's a pallet in the corner, and that's going to release the golf ball, not a difference, but it's going to bring it into the room for you, and that won't happen if you don't snipe it in the other room, so that was the purpose of sniping that golf ball, brought it into there. But now you can jump up. Be sure you land on the ledge because you have to get a radar jammer. Now, this part's going to be kind of controversial, so I don't want any of this crap in the comments. Oh, he's stealing from other puzzle maps! Because it's been used in two big puzzle maps done by groups. I don't want to hear it. It's been done in Pharaoh's Crypt, which was Creech and Spawn's map, and it's been done in Curtains Up on the Show, and probably a bunch of other ones. So just don't give me or him any crap about how he's using one challenge that was in a different puzzle map. In a bunch of different puzzle maps, actually. So, now you're going to clip through the wall again after you got the mongoose over the wall there. And you're going to fall down this little shaft here. And there's a firebomb grenade in the floor, which you're going to have to walk around kind of to find. Probably in the crack. That's what she said. And, just light the pallet on fire and fall down into the crypt hole. That's what she said again, and you got the oddball. So there you go. That was Dead on Sight by Ump and Thump. Very good map. I really like this map. I was really impressed by how well it was forged, and I don't know. I'm sure you can expect some more good stuff coming from him, and I think that's all for now. So this is ShadowWolf810, and I will see you all in my next video.